السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Praise be to Allah alone. We praise Him and we seek His help. Whomsoever Allah guides is the truly guided one, and whomsoever Allah leaves astray, none can show Him guidance. My dear viewers everywhere, welcome to the very first episode in the series of the history of Hajj. Many people take it for granted when it comes to religious knowledge. They think that they know everything about the deen. They think they know everything about the Kaaba, about Hajj. But unfortunately, this is not true. In this series, it is a humble attempt to explain to the viewers almost everything that they need to know about the history of Hajj. When was the Kaaba first built? Built by whom? And when was the Hajj prescribed? And the rites of Hajj, and also concerning the other sacred places such as the prophetic masjid and the farthest mosque in Jerusalem, and the relationship between the three masajid, insha'Allah Azza wa Jal. First of all, the question which imposes itself on us, which is that when was the Kaaba built and who built it first? Because in fact, there is a difference of opinion in this regard. Some historians, based on some narrations, those narrations are weak narrations, believe that the Kaaba was first built by the angels. And others believe that the Kaaba was first built by Prophet Adam, peace be upon him, when he was sent down to earth. There is a third opinion which believes that it was built by Sheth, peace be upon him, Adam's son. And there is a more right view, or the most right view in this regard, which claims that the Kaaba was built first by Prophet Abraham, peace be upon him. So let's see what the Quran says in this regard. But before we refer to the Quranic references, I would like to explain one thing. When we say Baytullah al-Haram, what does it mean? The word Baytullah, Allah's house. It doesn't mean at all that Allah lives in this house. Any masjid, any place of worship is known as Baytullah. Ascribing the creation to the Creator is to honor it, is to give it some sort of sacredness. When we say Allah's house, it is like Allah's earth, Allah's heaven. It belongs to Allah. It is created by Allah the Almighty. It is sacred because it is Allah the Almighty who made it sacred, as we will be learning, inshallah, whether in this episode or in the future episodes, inshallah. As far as the word haram, it means sacred. It is a sanctuary. There are a lot of things which you can do outside, but in Mecca, it is a sacred place you're not allowed to do. You're not allowed even to think about bad things. So bad thoughts are forbidden in the sacred place of Mecca. Allah the Almighty says in Surah Al-Imran, the third chapter of the Quran, in the two consecutive ayahs, 96 and 97,
إن أول بيت وضع للناس للذي ببكة مباركا وهدى للعالمين فيه آيات بينات مقام إبراهيم ومن دخله كان آمنا ولله على الناس حج البيت من استطاع إليه سبيلا ومن كفر فإن الله غني عن العالمين.
The meaning of these two verses that Allah the Almighty says, indeed, the first house for worship established for mankind was that at Mecca, blessed and guidance for the worlds. In it, there are clear signs such as the standing place of Abraham, and whoever enters it shall be safe. And due to Allah from the people is the Hajj to the house, pilgrimage to the ancient house, for whereever is able to find thereto a way. But whoever disbelieves, then indeed Allah is free from need of the creation. So according to this ayat, we learn that Al-Kaaba, the ancient house, is the very first place of worship to be put on earth. We've mentioned earlier the difference of opinions with regards to who built the Kaaba first. Why did we say that the strongest view that it was built by Ibrahim alayhi salam? It is because of another Quranic reference in Surah Al-Hajj, chapter number 22, verse number 26. Allah the Almighty said, وَإِذْ بَوَّأْنَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ أَلَّا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا وَطَهِّرْ بَيْتِيَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ وَطَهِّرْ بَيْتِيَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ وَالْقَائِمِينَ وَالرُّكَّعِ السُّجُودِ. Which means, and mention, O Muhammad, peace be upon him, when we appointed and designated for Abraham the site of the house, saying, do not associate anything with me in worship, and purify my house for those who perform tawaf, and those who stand in prayer, and those who bow and prostrate themselves in the prayer. We realize that Allah the Almighty have pointed out to Ibrahim alayhis salam the site of building the Kaaba, and designated for him where to erect the construction of the Kaaba. It is obvious that according to other Quranic references, that it was in Ibrahim by himself who built the Kaaba. The story begins as follows. When Allah the Almighty blessed Prophet Abraham, peace be upon him, finally with a child when he reached an old age and senility from Hajar, Allah the Almighty tested Ibrahim alayhi salam. He ordered him to take Hajar and Ismail, her son, the baby who was still being breastfed, into the desert, into a barren place, an uncultivated place. Ibrahim alayhi salam used to live in Asham. So he took them far away to the place which was known as Mecca. One of the names of Mecca is also Mecca. When he deposited them in this barren land, as the Quran said, Hajar, peace be upon her, called upon Ibrahim alayhi salam, and she said, are you going to leave us here alone? But he never replied back. She asked him again and again, and for a couple of times she said, Allahu amaraka bihada. Did Allah order you to do that? Look, he answered in the affirmative. Yes, indeed he did. At that, Hajar alayhi salam was in comfort, and she was assured, and she said, إِذَا لَنْ يُضَيِّعَنَ اللَّهِ. Then indeed, we will never get lost. Allah will never let this happen. Ibrahim alayhi salam left back to Asham. Hajar and Ismail remained alone there until Allah the Almighty made it easy for them to survive, and that will be explained in future episodes, inshallah. But here we're talking about the story of building the Kaaba first. Then years later, when Ismail grew up, and then Ibrahim alayhi salam was allowed to go and visit his son, and according to Abdullah ibn Abbas and the hadiths collected by Imam Bukhari, when they both met in Mecca, they did what a father and son would do when they meet after a long absence. They hugged each other, they greeted each other. Then Ibrahim alayhi salam said to his son Ismail that Allah the Almighty has ordered me and commanded me to do something. Would you assist me in it? He showed willingness. What was it? It was to raise the foundations of the Kaaba. So the ayah says, according to Surah Al-Baqarah, second chapter of the Quran, verse number 127, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلُ رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And mention, O Muhammad, peace be upon him, when Abraham was raising the foundations of the house, and with him, Ishmael, saying, both of them were invoking Allah the Almighty throughout the process of building the Kaaba, our Lord, accept this from us. Accept this work from us. Indeed, you are the all-hearing, the all-knowing. So according to this ayah, it was Abraham and his son Ismail, peace be upon them, both who built the Kaaba. Then the ahadith explained, Ibrahim alayhi salam was in charge of building and putting the bricks on top of each other, while Ismail was in charge of bringing the rocks and the stones, making sure that they are even bricks, so that he would hand them over to Ibrahim and he will put them on top of each other without any binding materials, with no cement. So that is the original building of the Kaaba, no clay, no mud, no cement between the bricks in the beginning. He was shown by Allah the Almighty the pillars of the Kaaba. These are the pillars and the boundaries of the Kaaba, where he started building the walls by putting the bricks on top of each other. When the building of the Kaaba was getting higher and they didn't have ladders, so Ismail alayhi salam brought him a stone in order to stand on top of it so that he can reach a higher level to add putting the bricks on top of each other. As a result, it remained and it left a footprint again as the stone. And this footprint remained until today. This stone, which had the footprint of Ibrahim alayhi salam, is known as Maqamu Ibrahim, which was referred to in ayah number 97 of Surah Ali Imran. Fihi ayatun bayinat Maqamu Ibrahim, such as the station of Ibrahim alayhi salam, that we can see clearly it is in a showcase a few yards away from the Kaaba. This stone, which have the footprint of Ibrahim alayhi salam, used to be attached to the Kaaba, very close to the Kaaba. But because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam once prayed before it, Umar ibn Khattab ordered that the stone should be sent distance from the Kaaba in order to allow people to perform tawaf freely. So it was Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail who raised the foundations of the Kaaba. It is quite interesting, brothers and sisters, in this ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah, that Allah the Almighty mentioned that while Ibrahim and Ismail both were building the Kaaba, they were busy making this beautiful dua, which is رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Qabool is the most important concern of the believer. It is indeed that Allah the Almighty who ordered them and honored them to build the Kaaba, but they were busy yet asking Allah the Almighty to accept this effort from us. Subhanallah, it is very interesting that in the beginning when Ibrahim alayhi salam deposited Hajar and Ismail alone, there was literally no life whatsoever. Allah the Almighty recorded this condition and what Ibrahim alayhi salam said in this regard in a beautiful ayah by the end of Surah Ibrahim, chapter number 14, verse number 37. Ibrahim alayhi salam invoked Allah as saying, رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِن ذُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ فَاجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ وَارْزُقُهُمْ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَشْكُرُونَ. According to this ayah, which means, our Lord, I have settled some of my descendants in an uncultivated valley near your sacred house, our Lord, that they may establish the prayer. So make hearts among the people inclined toward them and provide for them from the fruits that they might be grateful. This ayah, brothers and sisters, is the reference to those who say that basically the Kaaba was built even before Ibrahim alayhi salam. Because according to the ayah, it says that Ibrahim invoked Allah and he said, I have deposited and settled my family here in a place which is barren. عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ, nearby your sacred house. So there used to be a house of worship here. But where exactly, how did it look like? No one have any clue. But according to these sound references, we do not have any hadith or any ayah that described what was there before Ibrahim alayhi salam have built the Kaaba. And if anyone else, whether Adam or the angels or any other prophet, have built the Kaaba. And that's why we pause at this. And the ayah tells us that literally there was no life whatsoever, because when he says biwadin ghayri dhi zarra, in a valley which was uncultivated, it was unproductive of any fruits, but Allah the Almighty have turned everything into an entirely different world where it became the busiest place on earth. Inshallah, in future episodes, we'll continue talking about the remodeling of the Kaaba and the condition of the Kaaba since the past until today. Until next episode, I leave you all in the care of Allah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.